So today in this session we are going to discuss about Docker. So first introduction about Docker. Let me explain a little bit about Docker before getting into Docker completely, right? What is it knowing about it? Let's see few things, then we'll get there. So I have an application which is developed on Java 8 language. I have developed that Java 8 version. Now I have different environment. This is one Linux machine dev environment where I install Java 8. Here I have QA environment where I have installed Java 11. Pre-production where I have Java 7 installed, and production I have installed Java 8. Right? I have different versions on each environment. And due to some issues, right? And some other application, I have one more application which needs Java 11, which needs Java 8. Like that, I install different versions. Right? Now I have an application which is developed on Java 8. If I deploy the application here, will it work?
Yes.
Right?
Yes, sir.
If I deploy the 8 version in 11, where here the installed version is Java 11, but my application is developed on Java 8. So will it work here if I deploy?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It will work, because whenever Java is coming with the different version, it will latest version, it will support the APIs of previous version and plus new features. So it will support that. Now, if I deploy the same application in pre-production, will it work?
No, sir.
Why?
Lower version.
Yeah, the install is in lower version. The install is in lower version. Application is developed on higher version, but you have lower version. The Java 8 specification, the Java 8 features will not be supported here. So it will not work here. But if I deploy the same in production, it will work, right? So with this, is there any guarantee that if you deploy an application in one environment, the same application will work fine in other environments too? No, there is no guarantee, right? Maybe the Tomcat is different. Maybe Java, it's supporting. Here also I have Java 8. Maybe Tomcat version is changed, or else some other tool version is changed, right? There is no guarantee. Maybe database, something, not some database, something related to my project, the version is change the version compatibility issues I'm getting, right? So what we can do is there is one tool, right? So what is that tool? We'll see later. So what it will do is, whatever you need for your application, I need Java 8. If package everything, I need so and so var file. So right, so version we'll have, right? In the packaging, pound.xml packaging will read, right? One var file. That var file means Maven generated artifact, right? Next, I need Tomcat 9 or 7 or 8 or something, right? Whatever you need, Tomcat 8. Like that, whatever you need for your project, you package everything at keep at one place. So everything to run your, to deploy your project, whatever you need, everything is packed at one place for your application. So your application is used Java 8 or 10, 11, whatever you need. I have a Java application. So I converted that Java application as a var file. This is the var file. And to deploy this, I need a Tomcat. And to run that, I need a Java 8 version. Like that, you pre-pack everything. So this is going to be your dev environment. This is going to be your QA environment. This is going to be your pre-production, production, right? So here, whatever it is, whether it is a dev, production, pre-prod, right? What version of Java installed here? You no need to bother. Why? Because you have packed everything, right? You have packed everything here. You have packaged everything here. Now, if you want to deploy it in dev environment, you need to take this package and run it here. So automatically, when you take this package and run it here, right? This Java will be downloaded. This var file will be placed. Means you have to give this var file. I have to place inside Tomcat directory. So it will download Java. It will download Tomcat specific version. It will copy that var file here and it will start that Tomcat. Everything it will take care. You no need to install. You no need to install Java. You no need to install Tomcat. Nothing you no need to do. It is installation free, right? You just need to package it here. I need Java 8. I need Tomcat 8. And then I want to copy this var file. I have a var file. Copy this into Tomcat web apps directory and then start Tomcat. You no need to install them. Automatically, as you have packaged everything and said here, as per the package, it is going to download Java. It is going to download Tomcat. Place the var file inside Tomcat web apps directory and start your Tomcat. Now, Again, when I want to deploy the same package in QA, do I need to bother which version of Java is installed? Do I have Tomcat here or not? Do I need to bother?
No.
No, I don't need to bother. Maybe the Java 11 is installed here or 12 or Java 2, 1, 8, 6, whatever it is, right? We don't bother. Why? Because everything we packaged here, we are going, as per the package, automatically one tool is going to download and install them. What is that tool is called? That's Docker. Okay. Docker is a containerization tool. Okay. Containerization tool. Okay. What is this containerization? We'll discuss slowly, one by one, we'll discuss. Don't worry. So with the Docker, what we can get is we can get the benefit of this version. We can solve the issues of this version compatibility. So either you are deploying in a dev or QA, production, pre-production, you no need to bother what version of applications or softwares you are going to have. Nothing, you no need to worry. Why? Because everything will be packaged at one place, right? This, the packaging and kept one place. This packaging is called as image. This packaging is called as an image. This is a Docker terminology. Okay, image. Now, when you take this package, means when you take the image and run it, a container will be created. That is nothing but your application. That is nothing but an application. The running form of this image is called as container. Okay, again, we'll discuss more about this images, containers, Docker, containerization, virtualization. Again, we'll discuss in detail. You leave that to me. I'll give you from basics to expert level. You leave that to me. But for now, the packaging, right? The prerequisites, whatever required for my application, your packaging, right? That package is called as image. Now, when you want to get them actually, see here you have everything, right? Now you want to download and install them, everything you have to do, right? So what you have to do is for that image, you have to create a container. Means the running form of that image is called as container, okay? So now in the container, I have Java downloaded, Tomcat downloaded, web apps, var is copied into web apps directory and Tomcat has started. Now when I want to run it on a different environment, I don't want to bother whether I have whether I need to download or anything or which version of Java or Tomcat I have. Nothing you need to worry because everything is packaged here. Take it, run it. You want to run it on other environment, take it and run it. You want to run it on other environments, dev or prod, anywhere it is, just take it and run it. That's it. It will take care of that. Okay? Understood? So with this, our job is going to be easy, right? So we no need to bother where we are running or what software versions we have. We no need to worry, and we no need to install also. It is installation free. You no need to install also. Like I want to connect to my dev server, install Java. I want to go to QA, install Java. You no need to do that because Docker is taking care of that. You just prepack everything and give it, convert as an image and keep it there. Docker will take care of that everything, the installation parts. Understood, guys? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now listen this. So now what is Docker? Docker is a containerization tool. Okay, what is this containerization? So before going to this containerization, let's discuss about virtualization. What is this virtualization? We'll discuss. Okay, I have a operating system, means I have one OS, means I have an infrastructure, means one like a desktop or laptop, something which is coming with a 500 GB hard disk. 100 GB hard disk, and 32 GB RAM, and it is of Red Hat. Okay, Red Hat. Oh, right now I have this. Now what I want to do is, for my one of my application, I have purchased this, forget about AWS cloud. I don't have AWS, right? This is a normal virtual machine somewhere in US. It is physically existing, not AWS one. I'm maintaining it, or else we purchase this virtual machine, right? Now, I want to divide this into different machines. Means this is a Red Hat OS, right? I want to 500 GB, 32 GB RAM, which is high configuration for me. Now, what I want to do is I want to divide it into four operating systems again. One, I want to take it for dev, one for QA, one for pre-production, one for production. So the same mission, I want to divide it as four operating systems. The Red Hat operating system, one mission I have. I want to split this into four missions. So can I directly install an operating system on one on other operating system? Can I do that? On one operating system, can I install one more operating system directly? Is that possible?
No.
No, it's not possible. It's not possible, right? It is not possible. Directly, it is not possible. Indirectly, it is possible. So what we have to do, right? On your operating system, means whatever the laptop you have, right? You have to install something called as VirtualBox or Vagrant or VMware. There are so many virtualization tools. So virtualization spelling, I forgot, let me. Okay. So virtualization tool you have to install, right? So one of the virtualization tool you have to install. So what are those virtualization tools are like, right? You have something called as Vagrant, VMware, right? VMware, like that, there are different tools, VirtualBox, VMware, Vagrant, like that, there are different tools. You can install one of the tools. So they support virtualization, right? They support virtualization. Virtualization is one of the concept. Virtualization is one of the concept where you can split this one operating system into multiple operating systems, right? But that virtualization concept, to support that, there are multiple tools like VMware, Vagrant, VirtualBox. See, let me show you one VirtualBox, right? So let me show you that VirtualBox, right? So VirtualBox, just a second, guys. One second, I'll be back. Just a second. Okay, see this? I have an virtualization tool. So let me show you that. I said I'll show you, right? VirtualBox. So this is one of the VirtualBox I have. By mission, I have a VirtualBox. Okay, my system is slow, a little bit hand. So what you can do is, you can have that VirtualBox. Okay, install, I don't want this. I'll show you it, guys. Okay, I have it, I have a shortcut. Somewhere I have it, I forgot. I think I already installed it. I have it ready, let me. Here it's not there. Okay, leave it. I'll show you. So what we'll do with that is, what we will do is, we will install that VirtualBox tool here. In this, using that virtualization tools, what we can do is, we can split this operating system into multiple operating systems. Means, on top of this operating system, we cannot directly install one more operating system. So what we'll do is, we'll take help of virtualization tools, and using that virtualization tools, we'll install multiple operating systems here. So on this, right, I installed VirtualBox, one of the virtualization tool. Here, I'm going to install one more Red Hat operating system, Red Hat. But from this 500 GB, here I already have Red Hat with 500 GB and 32 GB RAM. No, I don't want that. I want to create one more operating system with Red Hat OS, right? And which needs only 100 GB of hard disk and 8 GB of RAM. 8 GB of RAM. Okay. So now, as this is of higher configuration, I want to split it. Means you have a laptop with 500 GB and 32 GB RAM, right? Windows machine or Red Hat machine or Mac, whatever it is, right? You want to divide it as two more computers. It's not possible directly. So what you can do is, you can take virtualization tools. You can take help of virtualization tools. And on top of that, you can install using, there are some different images, Red Hat image, CentOS image, like that. So there are different ways. So using that, what I'm doing is, in this 500 GB, I'm taking 100 GB. And from this 32 GB, I'm taking 8 GB. And I'm installing one Red Hat operating system here, right? So now, how much remaining here? From this 500 GB, I'm dedicating 100 GB for this operating system. So I want to create like one more virtual machine, like computer kind of thing, right? One more. And this is going to be a Ubuntu type. And here for this, what I want to do is, I want to give okay, I want to give same 100 GB and 8 GB or like 4 GB let me give. Done. So next I want to create one more CentOS. Okay. I want to create one more CentOS with 100 GB and 8 GB. Now tell me how. So I created three virtual machines, three instances. Means I have one big host. This is called as base OS or base host. Okay. Base machine means the main machine. These are called as virtual machines, means they are not physically existing, right? This is a main, means what the operating system, what we installed actually. So Windows operating system or Red Hat operating system. Again, that we split into multiple operating systems. These are called as virtual operating systems or virtual machines, whereas this is called as base OS or base host or base machine, right? So now from this 500 GB, I dedicated 100 for this. So remaining is 400. I dedicated for this and 300 remaining. In that 300, I gave it here, right? So total 300 GB I utilized and 200 GB is remaining, right? So in this 32 GB, I gave 8, 8, 4 here. So total 20 GB I utilized, right? Now, what I found is this operating system is fine. This is fine. But for this 4 GB is not enough. I want to increase the size. Right, while creating this operating system for this mission, right, I gave Ubuntu 100 GB and 4 GB RAM. But this 4 GB is not sufficient for this. I want to increase it. Is it possible? No, it's not possible when you are using virtualization. Right. So as a cost cutting or some issue, right, in the virtualization concept, right, as a cost cutting or something, right, I want to take a base OS with high configuration, right, Right. Instead of using this one mission, I want to split that into multiple missions. So I'm dividing like this. So remember one thing, if you are using virtualization concept, right? So you want to divide this base OS into multiple OSs, but while dividing, if you give any memory that is static, means it is fixed. If you give any memory like 100 GB, 4 GB, something like that, if you give it is fixed, you cannot change it. You cannot increase it or decrease it. See, in this, I have total of 32 GB. Right here, I utilized only 20 GB. So another 12 GB is free for me. I cannot take that 12 GB from that 12 GB and assign it to here, or else I cannot take from here and from. I found that for this 2 GB or 4 GB is more than enough. Other 4 GB is waste, right? So I cannot take the extra 4 GB and assign it here. That is not possible at all. So whatever you give it, whether you use that, I don't want 100 GB here. 10 GB is more than enough for me. 90 GB is getting wasted. But this mission needs extra GB. 100 GB is not enough for that. So can I take this 90 GB and assign to this? Is that possible?
No,
it's not possible, right? It is not possible. If you are using virtualization while splitting that operating system, means while configuring virtual machines on the base OS, if you are configuring any virtual machines, if you have given any configuration and created that is fixed. You cannot change that anymore. That is fixed. Okay, fine. So far we have seen this virtualization and version compatibility. Okay, let me go back. The same concept what I'll do is, I have a base OS, let me take this as it is. Okay, I have a base OS with this configurations. Instead of virtualization, I'm going to use one of the concept called as containerization. Okay, I'm going to use one of the tool called as containerization. NA, I think. Okay, spelling mistake. I'm very bad. 20, I think I wrote correct only, right? Okay, if not, let me replace it. Okay, we are going to use containerization concept. Instead of virtualization, containerization if you use, what is the benefit is, I want an operating system. I want an operating system with Red Hat, right? So I need this operating system, which is of Red Hat type. Now, while creating an operating system here, you no need to define how much memory you need for this. You no need to define how much hard disk or RAM is required for this. You no need to give. Why? Because if you don't give memory, what will happen is, for this operating system, at this moment, it needs 100 GB of hard disk and 8 GB of RAM. So it will directly take it from there. So from 500 GB, it will take 100 GB and 32 GB. Now, after 5 minutes, it don't want 8 GB of RAM. It need only 4 GB. What it will do is, earlier it was utilizing 8 GB, right? From that, it need only 4 GB. It will release the 4 GB here. So from that 32 GB, it was using 8 GB earlier. But now it need only 4 GB. It will release the 4 GB here. From that 32, right? Only 4 GB utilized now. 28 GB is free. Now, if there is one more operating system, if it needs 8 GB, okay, it will take this. It needs 16 GB after 5 minutes. Okay, it will take from here. Right? Have you understood? It is flexible here. Got it, guys? So there is no fixed memory. So whatever you need, it will take it from here. Whenever it don't want it, it will release us that. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next. One more thing is, I want to install Jenkins. For example, let's come here. So I want to split this into one of the missions, right? 3 missions. I want to install a Jenkins. For example, just think these three are not there. I want to install Jenkins. What should you do first? You have a virtualization tool. First, you need to create one operating system. Yes or no?
Yes,
first,
sir.
You need to create. Yes. And this, you want to download Java and then install Jenkins and all. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
But if you come here, it is operating systemless. If you want an operating system, you can get it. But if you don't want an operating system, you just need one Jenkins, right? Without operating system, you can install Jenkins. Without operating system, you can install Jenkins. Why? Because it is indirectly going to use the base OS. If you are using any containerization tools, you no need any operating system, right? How? Because it will take, you no need to have any operating system. It will directly take this operating system, but a shadow, like a proxy kind of thing, it will internally use an operating system. Listen my point again. I want to install Jenkins here. I want to install Jenkins here. For that Jenkins installation, you no need to create an operating system. And on that operating system, you no need to install Jenkins. Directly, you can use Jenkins itself. Directly, you can install Jenkins. All right? But you may get one question. Sir, to Jenkins, it needs one operating system, either Windows, Red Hat, CentOS, like that. But if you don't have any operating system, how does that work, right? It will internally uses this base OS itself. But as for temporary thing, it is going to create one proxy kind of, means operating system it will create, but that is not physically exist. It is not like this. Just one operating kind of thing, like an image kind of thing it will create. Just a shadow, like the proxy or shadow, whatever we call, just it looks like an operating system, but that is not an operating system. Internally, it is going to use the base OS directly. So remember, this is very much important. When you are dealing with containerization tools, you no need to have operating system. If you want an operating system for some purpose, you can have that operating system. But just to install your Jenkins, or else a Java application, KC Maven web application I want to deploy with Java, Tomcat and all, you no need to create operating system. Directly on this containerization tool, you run it, right? You have the package, right? That image where Java 8, Tomcat, WAR file, everything is there, right? You take it and create a container, it will create that. It will create that without any operating system. It will take the base OS and then create it. It looks like there is an operating system, but there is no operating system. It's like a image kind of, just a shadow kind of operating system, but which is not a actual operating system. It will indirectly uses this base OS only. Understood, guys? So whatever memory it needs, it will take that from 500 GB, 30 GB, whatever it needs, it will take that. Whenever it don't want it, release it. So other systems can, other operating systems or other tools, means these are called as containers. These are not like virtual machines. These are called as containers here. So this container needs some memory, it will take it. If other container needs more memory, it will take from here. It is flexible. It is no fixed version. Understood, guys? There is no fixed memory or static memory. It is flexible here. Understood, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what are the containerization tools? Is Docker. Docker and Rocket. There are something called as Rocket. Docker, Rocket. So, we are not going to learn Rocket. For our purpose, Docker suits, we are going to learn Docker only. So, what are virtualization tools? Can you tell me a few of the virtualization? Virtualization is a concept. To support virtualization, there are different tools. What are those? Can you tell me one, two, three names?
VMware, VirtualBox.
Vagrant. There are so many. Okay. Remember, VirtualBox, Vagrant, VMware. Okay. What are containerization tools?
Docker, Rocket.
So we are going to learn Docker. Okay. Fine. So now two things. If you use Docker, two benefits we'll get. We'll get two benefits. One is version compatibility. Right? We'll overcome this version compatibility issue. So if I install Docker here, I no need to bother which version of applications are there and all. Whatever the package I have, I'll take it, run it here. Automatically it will download. So I no need to bother about versions if I have Docker. Next thing, operating system free. I no need to bother about the which operating system here, that and all. I no need to bother, right? And the instances, whatever I have, that those are means the not instances here, containers. Those are flexible with the memory. I no need to bother what size of I have given here, whether it is sufficient or not. No, I no need to bother that, right? Memory is flexible here. Next one is installation free. So if I want to install my Java application here, if I package everything here, if I package, I need Java 8, I need Tomcat, I need this var file to be copied here, I need to start Tomcat. Like this, if you give, you just run that image as a container. Docker run that image. This image will have that packaging. That image will have some name. You give that. Automatically, your Docker will install Java. It will install Tomcat. It will copy that var file. Everything it will take care. It is installation free. You no need to install Java. You no need to set the path. You no need to download Tomcat. You no need to configure it as a service. Nothing you no need. It will take care of everything. Understood, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I have one question. I have packaged few things here. This is too much important. Concentrate. This is one, my application. Application A, consider it as, for example, Flipkart application. It needs Java 8. It needs Tomcat 8. Okay. It needs var file or some. Var file need to be copied into Tomcat. Fine. Now, I'm going to call it as an image. So whatever we need, right, that packaging, right, that is called as image. Now I'll take this, I'm going to create a container for this. So I'm saying the instructions, I need Java, I already downloaded Java and kept it here, Tomcat, everything. So when I take it, it will run those. Actually here itself we downloaded. Okay, in detail I'll discuss later. For now, just think, I have mentioned all the pre-packaging things here. I want to create a container. So container is nothing but application, means the Java is installed here, Tomcat is installed here, var file is copied here, Tomcat is started. Now I can access it. Okay, how to access that and all, we'll see later. Now I have one more application which also uses, this is Flipkart. Amazon has Java 8, it also needs Tomcat 8, and it has its own var file. Now if I take it and run it here, right, so it will create this is a Flipkart container. This is Amazon container. So as Flipkart is already downloaded Java 8 and Tomcat everything, will it utilize the same thing or it will download a separate set for this?
Separate set.
It will not use the same thing. It will use separate set. Okay. It will use a separate set. But again, it will not download everything that we will see in detail when we discuss. But for now, you remember it is a separate set. There is no link between this container and this container. For example, I ran it one container. I want to run one more application here. Means the same var file, one more container. Similar thing I want to create it here. Even though they both belong to the same image, same Flipkart image, I created two containers. So is there a relation between these two? No. Even though with a single image, if you have created two containers, those two containers are isolated, means one container is totally unique from other container. Understood?
sir.
Okay, so with the same image, you can create multiple containers in the Docker, but one container will not be related to the other container. You may think, okay, with this image only I created this container. Already Java Tomcat is downloaded. So if I use var file is there, if I create one more container, so they both will share the space or something? No way. The softwares, nothing they will share. They are totally different, totally isolated, totally different. Understood, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let me see this. So Docker is a containerization tool. Okay, I'm not given that definition. I have given in between, in the middle. Okay, so Docker images are like pre-compiled commands, means everything packaged there. Okay, we'll discuss about that. Okay, next. So the benefits of Docker is it's very fast, right? Dealing with Docker. So I want to create a container. For example, I have a package, right? I have a package. Let's see here first. I want to deploy my application here, my Java application. I want to, on a virtualization environment, I want to deploy my Java application. First, you need to create an operating system. Okay, I have an operating system. First, I need to install Java. I need to install Tomcat, then set everything, and then deploy my var file. I have to install Java, set the path. I have to install Tomcat, configure as a service, and then deploy it here. But when I am dealing with this container, right? I no need to do installation dot and all. What I can do, I can just run one command, single command, Docker run image name. Now this image will have name, Docker run image name. It will, you just give it, automatically it will create. It will install Java, it will download and install Java, Tomcat, copy the var file, everything it will take care. Understood, guys?
Sir.
Okay? Okay, fine. That is, it's very fast. If you want to create it or remove it with single command, you can remove it. With single command, you can run it, right? It's very fast. Memory saving and memory sharing. As I said, memory is shareable here. So whatever it needs, the memory will be sharing here. So it will save the memory. Next one thing is lightweighted. As I said, if this, I'll create one container, I'll create one more container. So it will have two set of Javas, right? Here one Java. If I have an Amazon application image, with that, if I create one more container here, it will have one more set of Java. You may get one question. For each application, means for each container, as it is getting downloading multiple versions of Java, right? So for one Java is taking 1 GB memory, it can take 3 GB Java, 3 GB for three applications, right? No, it's not like that. If it is taking 200 GB here in the virtualization concept, it will take around 200 MB. It is very lightweighted in Docker and Kube, I mean, in the containerization concept. I mean, I'm not going to use any containerization concept anymore. I'll call it as Docker. Means we are going to work with Docker only, right? If you have used Docker as your containerization tool, right? So it is very lightweighted. Next, time saving. As it is very fast to run and remove it, deal with it, it is time saving. Best resource utilization. As I said, memory is shared between those. It can use the agile, we will discuss this. Installation free. You no need to install the software. It is easy to create, stop, start, and remove the containers. Okay. Now, easy to pull and build the images, like pulling the images means I'll show you that. Okay, I'll show you that. We are going to learn that. Next, it no need of any operating system. Container can access operating system, which is not actually an operating system. Means it doesn't need any operating system. To run my Java application, I no need to create one operating system, pull the image and run it here. I don't want to do that. I directly on my Docker itself, I can create my application without operating system. It will create an mirror kind of operating system, but which is not an operating system. Instead, it is directly going to use the base OS itself. Whatever memory it needs, I need a Ubuntu. Okay, it will use Red Hat, but internally, it will treat like a Ubuntu, but internally, it is using Red Hat only. So like that, it will treat. Okay, so like proxy means like a mirror kind of image, but not a physical image, physical operating system, mirror kind of operating system. Okay, next. So let me show you this. So this virtualization concept. See, if you are using hypervisors, that hypervisors means that VirtualBox, VMware, and all, right? So if I'm using this virtualization concept, and if you have used any hypervisor like to support that virtualization concept, if I'm using hypervisors like VMware, VirtualBox, Vagrant, anything, right? First, I need to create an operating system. On that operating system, I need to install my Java application. That's right. Now, if it is a Docker, right? Docker engine. I no need to do that directly. I no need to have this operating system. Instead of that, directly I can install my application with the required binaries and all. Okay, it will come up. So this operating system, we no need in this containerization concepts. Okay, fine. Now, on a mission, if I install Docker, I'm going to get this components of Docker. Okay, I'm going to get this components of this Docker. This is nothing but a Docker architecture. Okay, we'll discuss this. Okay, so far, is it clear? The basics of Docker? What is containerization? What is virtualization?
Yes,
not in even the basics of Docker, I haven't discussed yet. Just at least the basic concepts. I mean, idea, basic idea about Docker, what it does, what is containerization, what is virtualization. Have you got it, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, we'll discuss the next concepts in the next session, right?